My name is Vishnu Gopal TV. I am a legal intern at Lecheson Company. I am from Corporate School of Law, Kerala. I am a third year student pursuing BBA LLB Honours. So today's topic for this video is essential elements of a valid contract. So the purpose of this video is to analyze about the essential elements of a valid contract. So according to Sir Frederick Pollock, contract means every agreement and promise enforceable at law. Section 2 clause H of the Indian Contract Act states that contract is an agreement which is enforceable at law. So section 10 of the Indian Contract Act states that all agreements are contracts if they are made by the free consent of the parties competent to contract with a lawful consideration and with a lawful object and are not hereby expressly declared to be void. So all contracts are agreements, but all agreements are not contracts. All agreements, in order to become a valid contract, they must satisfy all the essential elements which has been mentioned under section 10 of the Indian Contract Act. So the first essential element is agreement is equal to proposal plus acceptance plus consideration. So section 2 clause E of the Indian Contract Act defines an agreement. According to section 2 clause E, every promise and every set of promises forming consideration to each other is an agreement. So a valid offer when accepted becomes an agreement or a valid agreement. So here a valid offer must be made by one of the parties to the contract and the other party must accept that offer in order to become a valid agreement. So the next essential element is capacity of parties. It means in order to form a valid contract, the parties to the contract must have legal capacity to enter into the contract. So minors, unsound mind persons, insolvents, etc. doesn't have a legal capacity to enter into a contract. Consensus ad item is another important essential element. Section 13 of the Indian Contract Act states about consensus ad item. So consensus ad item as meeting of minds or identity of minds or receiving the same thing in the same sense. So the next essential element that has to be looked into is lawful consideration. Consideration is the return benefit the parties to contract get. So consideration, in consideration when one party does or gives something to another, he must be benefited by the other party. So this concept of benefit is termed to be as consideration. So now we can look into the next essential element, that is lawful object. So lawful object is another essential element or essential ingredient for forming a valid contract. So the object of the contract must not be illegal or it must not be opposed to any public policy. It must be legally valid. So one of the essential elements to constitute a contract is lawful object. So the next essential element is that the agreement might not be expressly declared to be void. So certainty and possibility of performance is another essential element to constitute a valid contract. It means the contract must be capable of performance. It must not be such an act which is impossible for performance, and the terms of the contract must be certain and capable of understanding. So intention to create legal relationship is another essential element. It means there must be an intention to create legal relationship. If there is no intention to create a legal relationship, then it does not give rise to a valid contract. So another thing is that if there is any prerequisite condition for the formation of a contract, it should be fulfilled before the conclusion of the contract. So that's another essential thing for a valid contract to come into existence. So finally, free consent is another important or essential element for forming a valid contract. Section 13 states that when two or more parties are said to be consented when they agree upon the same thing in the same sense. Section 14 says that or states that the consent is said to be free when it is not caused by coercion, undue influence, misrepresentation, fraud or mistake. So these are the essential elements that are required for forming a valid contract. So we have analyzed our topic in a detailed manner. So that's all about the topic. So you can like, you can subscribe, and you can comment on my video, and do like and subscribe our YouTube channel Let's Click. Please give me a feedback regarding this video, and if you have any questions relating to this video, you may please mention that question in the comment box, and I will be replying as soon as possible. And this video does not solicit any types of promotion or advertisement as per the guidelines of Bar Council of India, and the sole purpose of this video is for educational purposes only. So by saying these words, I'm concluding. Thank you.